make someone a gold medal memory today.
Again, it's our pleasure to say hello, everybody. Gold Medal Flower brings you the Ralph Emery Show, and our special guest is Mary Reeves. Mary, again, we say welcome.
Thank you.
And we've got some songs by Jim Reeves and some more stories about Jim Reeves to share with you. During Country Music Month, we're saluting Jim Reeves and his illustrious career. But first, who's going to open this show, Mary?
Connie Smith.
What's she going to sing?
She's going to sing, "If It Ain't Love, Just Leave It Alone."
If it ain't love, then let's don't even let it start. Let's leave it alone. If it ain't love, then let's don't tempt our foolish hearts. Let's leave it alone. Happiness is free, just like a rolling stone. And only love can make it stay at home. Feelings have a way of mixing. If it ain't love, let's leave it alone. If it ain't love, then let's don't even let it start. Let's leave it alone. If it ain't love, then let's don't tempt our foolish hearts. Let's leave it alone.
Our show opener from Connie Smith. Connie's singing, "If It Ain't Love, Just Leave It Alone." Hey, do you wish you could make fresh donuts without having to bother with the greasy mess associated with frying? Then just listen to this word from Gold Medal Flour.
Well, I'll tell you what I'm glad about. My wife has found a way to make me all the donuts I can eat on any day. I've always loved my donuts, but I used to have to wait. Now she makes the no-fry kind, the new gold medal way.
When the autumn season comes and leaves begin to fall, she bakes me up a big old batch, it's easy I can tell.
She doesn't have to mess around with all those pans and grease. She just puts them in the oven on a cookie sheet.
Cinnamon sugar to chocolate, and the applesauce is great.
They taste so light and tender,
the new gold medal way. The new gold medal way.
Just think, no more heavy, oily donuts. Sounds great, doesn't it? And the recipe is in sacks of gold medal flour. Mary Reeves is our guest. The subject is Jim Reeves. And Mary, when you met Jim Reeves, did you realize he was a thief?
No, I didn't.
I understand he was a thief.
Yes, in some ways, and at one particular time he was.
I guess there is an interesting story about most singers acquiring their first guitar. There are a lot of them.
Yeah.
And we have an interesting little story here that I think bears repeating, as Jim tells about, I think he was 7 years old, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm, somewhere around that.
Acquiring his first guitar.
Well, I saw this guitar in the yard of one of the neighbors. The lady had bought it for her son, and he became quite disenchanted with it for some reason. I guess his fingers got sore. But I could tell from the looks of the thing that he didn't care for it. It had been rained on and left out in the yard and so forth. So I got the idea to, steal some pears from a tree on the farm next to ours. And I took a fishing cane and knocked these pears down, sacked them up, took them to this lady, and traded them for this guitar. It had three strings on it. That's half of them. They're supposed to be six. I played it for about 6 months with these three strings, and a fellow came through the country there. In those days, they had pipelines for oil, you know, for the transmission of oil and gas across the country. When they were building these pipelines, they took everyone with them, that is, the cook tent, the ditch diggers, all the animals, and everything went along, and they moved each day or each 2 days as the ditch progressed in the laying of the line. Well, the cook, his name was Bill Price, knew some chords on a guitar. I was then seven, and he saw me with this guitar, and he wanted to teach me some chords, so he ordered some strings and keys and things for the guitar and fixed it up and taught me a couple of chords. And I became very interested and learned all I could about the guitar. I don't play well yet, but it has been a source of a lot of enjoyment for me.
Mary, how many of Jim's guitars do you now have?
I believe I have five.
He had that many?
Mm-hmm.
Boy, he did fall in love with the
guitar,
didn't he?
Oh, he did. He loved it.
By any stretch of the imagination, is that original guitar still in your possession?
Oh, no. No, that's long gone.
We're going to play a record by Jim Reeves called Distant Drums. And this was a hit after he passed on, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. In England, it was the number one record for 6 weeks in a row. And this is...
It was a big hit in this country, too.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh. And it was number one record here also.
The Cindy Walker song.
Yes. And she wrote it just for Jim.
I hear the sound of distant drums far away, far away. And if they call for me to come, then I must go. Share all the time we can before it's too late. Love me now, for now is all the time there may be. If you love me, Mary, Mary, marry me. I of bugles blow far away, far away. And if they call, then I must go across the sea. Distant drums might change our wedding day. And love me now, for now is all the time there may be. If you love me, Mary, Mary, marry me.
The voice of the immortal Jim Reeves, and the song is still rather appropriate, unfortunately. Jim Reeves singing Distant Drums. Now, Mary, a little preview of next week's show. You know who's going to be here?
Oh, Brother Jerry Reed.
You've been reading the copy here, haven't you?
Fooled you, didn't I?
Jerry Reed, the wild man, he'll be here to tell us about his recent adventures on network television this past summer, and a lot of things. And he'll be singing a lot of songs. And here's one song that comes from Jerry's brand new album.
Boogie, boogie, boogie. I got a gal that's mighty, mighty sweet. Got big blue eyes and tiny little feet. Her name is Rose, she's sweet as she can be. But she tips them scales at 303. Oh, but ain't it nice to have a gal so fat that when you hug her, you don't know where you're at. You have to take a piece of chalk in your hand, then you hug away and chalk away to see where you began one day. While I was hugging and a-chalking and a-chalking and a-hugging away, I met another fella with some chalk in his hand, coming round from the other way. Coming round the mountain, to the hills and the valleys. Sick and I never been weak. My bones don't ache and my joints don't creak. But I get a little dizzy and I get a little limp. Every time I lay a kiss on my baby blimp. Oh, but ain't it nice to have a gal so fat that when you hug her, you don't know where you're at. You have to take a piece of chalk in your hand, and you hug a while and chalk a while to see where you began one day. While I was hugging and a-chalking and a-chalking and a-hugging away, I met another fella with some chalk in his hand, coming round from the other way. Looking kind of funny. One day, while I was hugging and a-chalking and a-begging her to be my bride, I seen another fella with some chalk in his hand, coming round from the other side. Speaking up easy. Now, honey, I ain't saying you fat. But when you sit down all over the place. Keep me shady in the summer. Keep me warm in the wintertime. Honey, hand me the chalk, I think I love you.
That's Jerry Reed hugging and choking. When you shop, do you buy unknown brands in order to save a few pennies? You may be fooling yourself. Take flour. I know lots of cooks who have saved a few cents on an inexpensive brand, only to have a baking failure. So they lose much more than a few cents in wasted eggs, milk, shortening, and goodness knows what else. That's why it's smart to buy gold medal flour. Gold medal is tested at the mill before it's packed, and then in the Betty Crocker kitchens for quality and uniformity to ensure superior baking results every time. So no matter what you bake, from desserts and breads to main dishes, you know you can count on the best results with gold medal flour. You may pay a little more, but you'll save in the long run. Now let's listen to a recent guest on our show. Fact is, she was here last week, Miss Jeannie Shepherd.
In the sunshine, through fields of clover sparkling with the dew. Loving you is just like walking in the sunshine. It's such a happy feeling just knowing that I have you.
There's no storm clouds up above me, not when I know that you love me. If it rains, it never rains on me. I don't carry an umbrella. I'm your gal and you're my fellow. When I'm with you, sunshine is all I see.
Loving you is just like walking in the sunshine, through fields of clover sparkling with the dew. Loving you is just like walking in the sunshine.
the darkest of the night time. I don't even know it's night time. I just dream of sunny days and you. When I look into your love eyes, you're the one who makes the sunrise. Skies are never gray, they're always blue.
Loving you is just like walking in the sunshine. Through fields of clover sparkling with the dew. Loving you is just like walking in the sunshine. It's such a happy feeling just knowing that I have you. It's such a happy feeling just knowing that I have you.
Little old Jeannie Shepherd singing Just Like Walking in the Sunshine. And we turn to Mary Reeves now for the next guest.
Who was Jim Reeves' favorite male singer?
You're kidding.
That's right. Marty Robbins.
He's about everybody's favorite,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah.
One of them anyway.
That's right. And he's going to sing This Much of It.
Janet, I believe that it's about time that we stop and talk things over. There's a lot of things about life, Janet, you're too young to understand. You think life with me is like a field of clover. I can satisfy you now, but I won't always be this much a man. Janet, there's not too much chance that we're gonna make it through this life together. And the reason I'm believing is there's more than 20 years between our age. Right now skies are blue, but later on will come a stormy weather. Life is like a book, and let me tell you, Janet, I've read every page. You find satisfaction and contentment just lying here in my embrace. But let me tell you once again, you wake up some morning and be looking in some old and wrinkled face. But I can't make you understand why you're lying here and crying like you're crying now. And it's hard to think while kissing you when no one else can kiss me like you can. And all the time you're trying to reassure me that my youth ain't dying now. That I'll never be too old, that I'll always be this much a man. You keep on telling me that you don't expect no more from life than I can give. Janet, I'm just fool enough to try to be that big a fool if that's the way you think you want to live. Janet, I'm just fool enough to try to be that big a fool if that's the way you think you want to live.
Mr. Marty Robbins on the show. Mr. Teardrop singing This Much a Man. And now, Paul Ott.
I remember, ooh.
I remember when I was a little boy, how Dad would take all the family in the pickup truck to town on Saturday. Ooh. And I remember one time how Mr. Durkin, who ran the general store, told us how Mother started shopping there when she was an 18-year-old bride. Mr. Durkin said he told Mother how gold medal flour and a Betty Crocker recipe gives any cook a margin for error in case little things go wrong, like a mistake in measuring. And Dad said whatever he had told her sure had worked out fine. 'cause mother was the best cook in all the world. I remember how mother and dad looked at each other then, and how my brother Billy and I grabbed the gold medal sack and took it out to the pickup and pretended not to notice.
Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Oh, mercy, look who's here, Merle Haggard.
She was always there each time I needed you, holding on to me like I held on to you. We still don't have what you and I once had. No, it's not love, but it's not bad. No, it's not love, not like ours was. It's not love, but it keeps love from driving me mad. And I don't have to wonder who she's had. No, it's not love, but it's not bad. I turn to her when you leave me alone. Sometimes even when you're here and you're still gone, she's slowly changing what you leave so sad. No, it's not love, but it's not bad. No, it's not love, not like ours was. It's not love, but it keeps love from driving me mad. I don't have to wonder who she's had. No, it's not love, but it's not bad. No, it's not love, not like ours was. It's not love, but it keeps love driving me mad. And I don't have to wonder who she's had. No, it's not love, but it's not bad.
Merle Haggard singing a very provocative song called It's Not Love, But It's Not Bad. Ralph Emery with Mary Reeves is my special guest. We're playing a few records for you during Country Music Month. And Pat Roberts is a new singer, a new voice on the American country music scene, I'm told, from the state of Washington. Here he is.
Listen to the rhythm of the falling rain, telling me just what a fool I've been. I wish that it would go and let me cry in vain and let me be alone again. The only girl I care about is gone away, looking for a brand new start. But little did she know that when she left that day, along with her she took my heart. Rain, please tell me now, does that seem fair for her to steal my heart away when she don't care? I can't love another when my heart's somewhere far away. listen to the rhythm of the falling rain, telling me just what a fool I've been. I wish that it would go and let me cry in vain, and let me be alone again. About is gone away, looking for a brand new start. But little did she know that when she left that day, along with her she took my heart. Rain, won't you tell her that I love her so? Please ask the sun to set her heart aglow. Rain in her heart and let the love we knew start to grow. Listen to the rhythm of the falling rain, telling me just what a fool I've been. I wish that it would go and let me cry in vain, and let me be alone again. Listen to the rhythm of the falling rain, telling me just what a fool I've been. I wish that it would go and let me cry in vain, and let me be alone again.
That's Pat Roberts singing The Rhythm of the Rain. It's funny we should play The Rhythm of the Rain because of what we're about to do here. Mary, I want you to set the scene for me. We're going to play a portion of a live performance by Jim Reeves, and you can describe the scene if you will, please.
This was a park in Pennsylvania, a hillside park, and it was outside, and of course it was raining. And they had a good show and a good crowd, and this was sort of the mood.
Now, this is a live album, but Jim did not go there that day to record a live album, did he?
Oh, no. This man just had the sound truck there and wanted to do this tape, and Jim let him do it.
Then for his own amusement, was it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
How did you acquire it?
The engineer sent Jim a copy of this tape, and of course I still had it.
Then you in turn leased it to RCA Victor, I guess.
Yes, uh-huh.
All right, let's go back to that rainy Sunday in a Pennsylvania country music park, and here's a medley of some of your favorite songs by Jim Reeves.
Thank you very much. Now I'd like to sing a medley of songs here, if we can get the get our singers over to the microphone. You folks no doubt are familiar with the I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about my cotton picking feet wet, and this Duke thing up here is just shocking the far out of me.
He's from Texas, you can tell, can't you? Of course, he was real little when it happened and couldn't do anything about it. You've heard of the Jordanaires and the Modernaires. These are the Questionaires to help me sing here. Leo, if you'll start us off on something here.
Out where the bright lights are glowing, you're drawn like a moth to a flame. You laugh while the wine's overflowing, while I sit and whisper your name. Four walls to hear, four walls to see, four walls to hear me close.
Another one of my favorite songs.
Last night was the worst night of my life, no doubt. 'Cause while I stayed at home, someone else took you out. I cried 'cause I love you with all of
my mind, and I missed me, how I missed me at your house last night. I miss holding hands, walking out on your lawn. I miss the sweet kiss that was mine for so long. Were you happy with new arms wrapped around you so tight? I missed me, how I missed me at your house last night.
Couple of my favorite tunes that we just have to do.
I was waltzing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced him to my loved one, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night and the Tennessee waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. For I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beauty.
Now here's a question that nobody's ever answered yet.
How many arms have held you
and hated to let you go?
I wonder.
And here's a question I haven't been able to answer yet, but I'm sure glad somebody answered it.
Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low, and you can tell your friend there with you he'll have to go.
Oh, a lot of goodies there. Four Walls, I Missed Me, Tennessee Waltz, I Really Don't Want to Know, and a bit of He'll Have to Go, our Jim Reeves medley. Autumn's here, and you know what that means, donuts and cider. This fall, you can make your own donuts, a new easy way.
Sounds good, Ralph, but you can't really mean easy.
Oh, I certainly do, Mary, because Gold Medal Flour has come up with a recipe for no-fry donuts. That's right, you don't fry them. You bake them. Forget about hot spattery grease and deep fat frying. Just put them in the oven and you've got them made. They're cinnamon sugared, applesauce, or chocolate, and they all come out tender, luscious, and boy. When you make them, be sure and use Red Star yeast. It's the natural yeast with no preservatives, and it's dependable and easy to use. This fall, bake your family donuts the new and easy way. The recipes in gold medal sacks that say, no fry donuts. Now I think we'll listen to Bobby Gentry. Whatever happened to Bobby Gentry? Mercy, what a pretty girl, but we don't hear much about her anymore. But this is an old record, a song written by John Hartford.
You don't know me where I live, my tracks may soon go everywhere, because there ain't no other place for them to go. Where I dwell outside of now for me, that's really hard to say. Like sometimes I'm not really sure I even know. What's the difference being different when it's difference now that looks alike? You say I'm changing, I'm not sure that's wrong. It's just the center line on this highway runs up my guitar neck, and I feel somehow that it's natural to be gone. What crazy patterns do we follow sitting neatly up on some riverbank somewhere at supper time? The evening air is moving like molasses toward the sticky night so easy as I press your hand in mine. You seem a little colder when I say I must be leaving. What an ugly way for us to let it in. What's the use in being worried, cause I'm going in an hour when the time is running out that we could spend. What's the difference being different when it's difference now that looks like? You say I'm changing, I'm not sure that's wrong. It's just the center line on this highway runs up my guitar neck, and I feel somehow that it's natural to be gone. There's a season in my mind that I can count on for an answer. I've dug too many holes expecting snow. I'm not sure to where I'm headed, how I'll ride and who I'm with, if I return or when I think that I might go. What's the difference being different when it's difference now that looks alike? You say I'm changing, I'm not sure that's wrong. It's just the center line on this highway runs up my guitar neck, and I feel somehow that it's natural to be gone.
That's Miss Bobby Gentry, Bobby singing Natural to Be Gone. You know, a lot of disc jockeys listen to this program, Mary, and they might be sort of interested in this little excerpt we're going to play for them. We have a recording here of Jim Reeves as a radio announcer, don't we?
Yes, we do. Mm-hmm. It was his first audition to master for a job, really.
You mean this is something he cut to let them hear what he sounded like as an announcer?
Yeah, right.
Well, all right, and here's Jim to talk about it, and you will hear his audition.
I went into radio announcing for about 7 years. You know anything to keep from working.
From the wires of United Press, Jim Reeves reporting. The National Association of Real Estate Boards in its Washington local pleaded innocent this week to government charges of a conspiracy to fix commission rates. And the government itself made an embarrassing disclosure that because of what was termed hardship or community needs, permits have been granted since July 1st, 1948 to build theaters.
So, had a lot of fun in radio.
That was kind of scratchy, Mary. I guess that's on an old disc.
Yeah, it's very old. It's before the tape.
But that was his audition.
Yeah.
Did he get the job?
Yes, he did.
Mm-hmm. Was that in Henderson, Texas?
Yeah, Henderson, Texas.
That's the station that he bought and you now own today.
Yeah, that's right.
He went back and bought the station that he formerly worked for.
Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty good step forward. Have we got time for that wild story? There's a story that Jim was fired from that station, and that ultimately he went back and fired the man who fired him. Is that true?
No, not really. No, Jim left the station on his own accord, and of course when you station becomes under new management, usually somebody has to go, and as this turned out, the program director and manager had to go.
They did get fired then.
Yeah.
I see. Mac Davis is going to sing a song he wrote. We used to play this a lot by Ray Price. Here's Mac with The Lonesome is Lonesome.
Well, I scorched your favorite pen this morning, trying to make some pancakes. Spilled the grease and had to stop and mop the floor. Sat there like a little baby, crying in the cornflakes. I don't think that I could take it anymore. Baby, come home.
Baby, baby, come home.
This is the lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Late last
last night I woke up trembling with my arms wrapped round your pillow and a lump as big as Texas in my throat. Sat there in the dark and played my guitar till the sun came up and wrote the saddest song I ever wrote. Baby, come home. This is the lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Lonesomest lonesome, oh, the saddest sad, the loneliest I've ever been alone. The best thing this poor boy ever had. Now you're gone.
Now you're gone.
Well, tonight I'm gonna get down on my knees and say a prayer for the first time since I can't remember when. Maybe if I'm lucky, when I wake up in the morning, you'll be soft and warm beside me once again. Oh, baby, come home.
Baby, baby, come home.
This is the lonesomest lonesome. Lonesomest lonesome I've ever known. Oh, baby, baby.
Lonesomest, lonesome.
Oh, lonesome, baby.
Lonesomest, lonesome.
I
need
you, baby.
Lonesomest, lonesome.
Oh, come on, baby.
Mac Davis singing the words. The beautiful song, The Lonesomest Lonesome. Now let's listen to the gold medal singers as they remind us of something nice.
Make someone a gold medal memory today.
Mama would call from the kitchen door, come on, it's time to bake some more. I'd be there on the run, 'cause I knew we'd have lots of fun.
Baking up a gingerbread man, baking up a gingerbread man. Get the gold medal flour and the baking pan, baking a gingerbread man.
Now my daughter's 6 years old, and she doesn't have to be told. When it's gold medal baking day, I can always hear her say,
we're baking up a gingerbread man, baking up a gingerbread man. Get the gold medal flour and the baking pan, baking a gingerbread man, baking a gingerbread man. Make someone a gold medal memory today.
It has been our pleasure to have Mary Reeves as our guest. As we have been saluting Jim Reeves, Mary, thank you so very much.
Thank you, Ralph. It's just been lovely.
I'll say that I'm sure the fans have enjoyed hearing all this music again.
Yeah, I hope so.
You seem like you've enjoyed it.
I have. I never get tired of listening to that.
We're going to close the show with the current Jim Reeves hit, Missing You.
Missing you, can't help but wish that you were in my arms tonight, making love to me. Kissing you, that's all I want. Seems just right now that we're apart. I always spend my time just writing lines to you. Can't wait for you to write, saying you love me too. Missing you. Can't help but wish that you were in my arms tonight, making love to me.
I always spend my time just writing lines to you. Can't wait for you to write, saying you love me too.
Missing you. Can't help but wish that you were in my arms tonight, making love.
Jim Reeves, Mr. Velvet, Gentleman Jim, concluding our program this week with Missing You. As part of our salute to Country Music Month, we have brought you the voice of Jim Reeves and our special guest, Mary Reeves. Mary, again, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Ralph Emery for Gold Medal Flower, thanking you for listening, and join us next week, won't you, when Jerry Reed will be our guest.